you know, this week is International Fight Week. For me to go through everything that will be going on would be crazy and take way too long. So anybody who's coming into town this week for Fight Week and all the events that we have going on, or people that are already here, if you don't know what's going on or where it is, go to UFC.com. All the information is there. That's it, man. Here we are. UFC 148, one of the most anticipated fights in UFC history. This is a big one. I'm pumped. I know you guys are pumped. Who's got the first question? Raise your hands. They'll bring you a microphone. Oh, and one more thing. I want to thank Legacy Stadium for letting us come here and hold a press conference. This is an awesome place. Woo! For a press conference. Thank you.
For Anderson, please. Anderson, yesterday Dana made it pretty clear that this was a fight you didn't originally want and didn't want to give Chael a rematch. Some people say that's because the fight was so tough for you the first time around. Can you explain why it is that you didn't want to give Chael this fight?
Ontem o Dana falou numa entrevista que você realmente não queria essa luta com o Chael e você acha que ele não merece revanche. E isso é porque a primeira luta era tão difícil ou por que é isso?
Eu tô aqui para lutar com qualquer um, independente de quem seja. É lógico que, na minha opinião, talvez não vá valer muita coisa, mas eu tô aqui para lutar.
I'm here to fight whoever they put in front of me, and I guess sometimes maybe my opinion doesn't make too much of a difference, but I'm here to fight whoever they put in front of me.
Thank you. And for Chael, obviously you've spoken candidly throughout the build-up to this fight. Some Brazilians say maybe you've crossed the line, you've gone a little bit too far. I'm curious, you know, is there anything that you regret along the way, and how would you address those Brazilians and say, hey man, you know, you went beyond hype, you went a little too far in some of the things you said?
First off, I offer absolutely zero apologies. And secondly, listen guys, if you're not willing to go too far, you will never go far enough in life. And I don't care. I don't promote fights. I pick fights. I'm like John Jones. I sound like Sean Combs. And I got trombone-sized stones like John Holmes.
Muita gente se impressionou com a maneira que você falou na conferência telefônica. Eu queria saber, você nunca tinha respondido do mesmo jeito para o Sonnen. Qual foi o motivo? Você simplesmente não aguentava mais ouvir o que ele falava quieto ou você quis entrar nesse jogo de trash talk?
Não tem jogo nenhum.
The question was, is we've never heard you in the phone conference call talk the way you did. What was the decision on why you act that way?
Não tem jogo nenhum. Acabou a brincadeira. Não tem mais brincadeira. Pode ficar, continuar falando bobagem, mas acabou. Sábado, as coisas vão mudar. Muita coisa vai mudar.
Playtime is over. He can say whatever he wants. Like I said it last week, and I'll say it again. It's over. Saturday, a lot of things are going to change. It's going to be much different after Saturday.
I have a question for Chael. Chael, as you said, why do you think Anderson's next at the conference call?
Well, listen, if you knew your funeral was coming up, you'd probably have some parting words as well. You know, it's nice to see the real Anderson come through. I don't mean his funeral in a morbid way, but it's a funeral of a career, man. This is coming to an end. On 7-7 at 7 p.m., 10 in the East, and only on pay-per-view. Chael Sonnen Promotions in conjunction with Zuffa LLC will bring to you Sonnen vs. Silva 2, the end. He will step aside, and the man will walk through.
Richard Hunter, KRLD, Dallas. Question for Chael. Chael, the UFC is running promos highlighting your loser leave town stipulation for this fight. Can you clarify for the record that you have rescinded that offer, and if so, what motivated you to pull it off the table?
Well, that's the way that offers work. I put it out there, he didn't accept, and I had a fight with Munoz, and then ended up fighting with Bisping, and it didn't work. I mean, it was anything I could do to lure him into this match. So, you know, that offer got put out. There's been a lot of them that were put out there, but yes, it is rescinded. Yes. Chael Sonnen is not going anywhere. Yes.
Uh, Anderson, o cenário dessa luta mudou um pouco, né? No começo seria no Brasil, com a torcida brasileira a seu favor, acabou vindo para os Estados Unidos no final de semana da independência americana. É, isso mexeu um pouco com você, ou mudou a sua estratégia para essa luta? Como é que você se sente aqui em Las Vegas?
This fight has changed a lot. You know, it started off being in Brazil, and now it got changed to Las Vegas in America on Independence Weekend, 4th July weekend. How do you feel about this?
Para mim não mudou muita coisa. Desde que eu cheguei aqui, houve muita polêmica em relação ao que o Anderson estava proposto a fazer dentro do UFC. E eu acho que o povo americano que assiste o UFC viu o Anderson que há muito tempo não via nenhum outro tipo de lutador. E é isso que eu vim fazer aqui, vim fazer o meu trabalho, independente de qualquer coisa, eu respeito os americanos e tenho certeza que eles respeitam o meu trabalho, e é isso que eu vim fazer aqui, fazer o meu trabalho.
It doesn't really make too much of a difference where this fight is at. I'm going to do my job, whether anywhere in the world. You know, I came here and regardless, you know, the fans who see the type of work that I do inside the Octagon, and regardless of if you're American or what country you're from, I respect all the countries, and I respect, I'm sure that they respect my job that I do inside the Octagon.
Anderson, você é o maior campeão da história do UFC. Com todas as provocações do Charles Sonnen, tem como não levar essa luta para o lado pessoal?
With all the controversy that Chael Sonnen has been saying, is there a way to take this fight as a professional and not take it personal? Of course there is.
Question for Anderson. Anderson, a lot of people talked about Chael's wrestling in the first fight, but he outstruck you as well, especially early in the fight. Were you unprepared for his striking, and do you feel like you can turn that aspect of it around in the rematch?
Muitas pessoas sempre falam do wrestling do Chael, mas na primeira luta ele então bateu em você mais que você bateu nele. Você fez umas coisas no seu treinamento para mudar isso nessa luta? For him to be able to strike with me standing up, he has to be a magician. It's impossible for him to stand up with me.
Chael, do you have a response?
Why are you asking questions in English? Anderson sits here like he doesn't understand you. Ed Soros interprets, and we got to hear it a second time. First off, he speaks English, and second, we could replace Ed Soros with an app I could download for $9.99. What kind of world are we in here? This is the strangest thing I've been part of. You know, people ask me if I wanted to go to Brazil for the fight. Sure, it'd be neutral territory. Anderson lives in a mansion in Beverly Hills. Las Vegas, Nevada is closer to him than it is to Westland, Oregon. He's got home court advantage. What are we even doing here, guys? This is insanity. He sits over and pretends he doesn't speak English? Come on. Like pretending you're the world champion. I can't believe... Guy walks around with a fake belt. That's insane. I would never do that.
Oh, he went too far with the fake belt.
Come on. You guys bet.
It's kind of like the way you speak Portuguese, right, Joe?
Exactly. $9.99 app on my iPhone.
Você se preparou da forma com que você se preparou para essa, e nós vimos um dos seus treinadores dizendo que para a primeira luta contra o Chael você não estava 100%. Dessa vez a gente vai ver o Anderson 100%.
Do you remember the difference of getting ready for the first fight with Chael in comparison to getting ready for this fight? And we heard one of your trainers say that in that first fight you weren't 100%.
Claro.
Of course.
Ah,
you, I guess, maintain the calm? Because you can, I can kind of see, you know, the, I can kind of just see, you know, the stress coming off. What are you doing to, you know, maintain that level of calmness before you step into the octagon on Saturday night? Like, what's keeping you from, you know, getting real personal?
Don't answer yet, Anderson. You gotta pretend you understand.
It's a wrap.
Você se sentir tão tranquilo assim e não deixar isso passar dos limites?
Ah, se você treina 100%, o resultado é 100%. E eu vou 100% treinado, o resultado vai ser 100%.
If you train 100%, the result will be 100%. I'm 100% trained, and the results are going to be 100%. This question is for Chaela. The road to a championship bout is a hard one, and the fact you've managed to get here twice now, do you feel like there's any more pressure this time around for you to get this belt, because it may be your last?
Yeah, you know, you got to understand, you have to earn pressure. If I just walked into this thing and I was green and it was my first time at the dance, I wouldn't have anything expected of me. I have earned the right to feel pressure. And, you know, it doesn't matter how I feel. Happy, sad, sick, indifferent on 7-7 at 7 p.m., 10 in the East, and only on pay-per-view. They are going to call my name, and my music hits those speakers. I'll put that mouthpiece in, and I will make that walk because I said I would. I signed a contract, and I'll do it, no matter how I feel, no matter about pressure or anything else. And when Bruce Buffer gets out of my way and that ref says fight, I will.
Anderson, a lot of folks maintain that you are the greatest fighter in the history of the sport. Just want to know where you see yourself added in the pantheon of greats in the sport.
Muitas pessoas falam que você é o melhor lutador que já lutou nesse esporte. Como você se sente quando as pessoas comentam isso?
Eu tento manter sempre o meu foco. Acho que ser o melhor não é um fato, né? É uma opinião. Então, você tem que estar sempre focado, treinado, com os pés no chão.
I have to stay focused, you know. When someone says that I'm the greatest, that's not a fact, it's an opinion. So I just try to stay focused and try to, you know, keep my feet on the ground and just stay focused to do my best.
And then for Dana, you've obviously been pretty clear on your thoughts on where Anderson ranks with the all-time greats. If he were to lose on Saturday, does that knock him down a couple of days?
No, everybody loses. One of the things I think that's even more amazing about Anderson is everybody has realized it's like 38 years old, too, you know, and the guy is still performing at that level, which is a feat in itself. He's still the greatest, you know, the pound-for-pound best fighter in the world at that age and has shown no signs of slowing down whatsoever, and I do believe that he is the best ever.
And, Chael, do I dare ask you where you see Anderson in the list of all-time great fighters?
Listen, man, his record speaks for itself. He's a good, durable fighter. He's the champion, but I am the best, and there can be only one. I'm not going to make any apologies for that. You know, he's done a good, solid job. He's a durable guy. I'm a world-class athlete. He's a martial artist. I'm a cage fighter, and there's a tremendous difference. And on Saturday night, it's going to be one more in the win column, one more for the highlight reel, and one more for the bad guy.
Question for Chael Angel from the MMA Tribune in Puerto Rico. Chael, can you talk about your actual motivations behind this fight and your drive to be a champion?
Well, I mean, listen, this is the entire point of sport. It is for championships. It's Olympic year, you know. It's about sacrifice and getting to the top. And I hear some guys, you know, for some guys it's about respect. And I don't know what that's about. This is a fight. It's a competition. There can be only one. Your skills against my skills. Your heart against mine. Your sacrifice against mine. And there's no point in paying the prices that I've paid for anything less than to set your goals at the top.
For Anderson, any concern that you might, from you or anyone in your camp, you might come into this fight too emotional? And maybe drive away from the fight plan a little bit.
Tem nenhuma preocupação com você ou nenhum dos seus treinadores que você vai entrar nessa luta com muita emoção e vai tirar você da sua estratégia?
Nope. Last question for Dana. You have to stand up here and listen to Chael say, I don't promote fights, but then he says, Chael Promotions in conjunction with Sufi LLC, you have to laugh about what he says. What do you think when you listen to him say stuff like that?
I've heard him say it all. I've been in some crazy places where he said it all, and you know, I don't know if we've heard it all, but it's Chael. It's just, you know, the thing about Chael is, and I said this before, is I respect the fact that he does talk a lot, but he goes in and he fights. The guy definitely backs up his talk, so.
Yeah. Yes.
A question for Chael. Chael, up here. All your criticisms and witticisms are all quite calm and calculating, and very, very entertaining, I must hasten to add. Last week, when Anderson Silva kind of spilt the beans emotionally in that conference call on the phone, did you take something from that? And was there anything you left out of it in terms of the criticism he poured forth towards you?
No, I don't. You know, there's no gamesmanship here with me. I'm not trying to get in his head. I don't even really know what that means. You know, look, he erupted, the real Anderson came through. You know, he tried to talk down to me like I'm Vitor Belfort and I'm going to wilt and go in a corner. The fact is I've been picking a fight for 2 years and it looks like I found what I'm looking for.
Yeah.
Chael, to follow that up, where do you go if you're unsuccessful on 7-7? Where did you go mentally after the devastating loss that you had been in of being the champion? Where do you go from here?
Well, listen, it's like anything in life. You know, you put one foot in front of the next either way. After this fight, I will do the same thing I always do, which is take my Aunt Paulette out and get her a lobster tail.
This question for Anderson. Anderson, there's a lot of rumors out there that you might retire after this fight, win or lose. Have you entertained any thoughts on retirement?
Tem muitos fofocas rolando, falando que você vai se aposentar depois dessa luta, ganhando ou perdendo. Tem alguma verdade?
Não.
Questions for Anderson, right here in the middle. You know, you listened to Chael Sonnen do all this stuff for 2 years, 2.5 years, and you never really responded to it. So why did you choose the conference call to come out and say all this? Did you just want him to know what you were planning to do to him? Was it just emotions? Were you having a bad day? Was it to hype the fight? Why choose that particular moment to come out in a way that none of us had really heard you before?
O Chael Sonnen teve falando muita besteira nesses últimos 2 anos e meio. Por que você escolheu para falar uma resposta de volta para ele naquele conference call? Foi por quê?
Olha só, acabou a brincadeira. Vocês não estão entendendo o que vai acontecer. Acabou a brincadeira. Não tem mais brincadeira. Chael, em outras palavras, tá ferrado.
You know, I have no words to really explain it other than the game is over. The game is over. You guys will see on Saturday night what I'm talking about. I don't have anything else to say other than he's screwed.
Anderson, Rádio TV Guarapuava, Paraná, Brasil. Muitas pessoas acham que o Chael Sonnen não estaria capacitado e credibilizado para entrar, para estar fazendo essa luta com você. Através dos seus depoimentos, ele chegou nesse momento. O que você tem a dizer sobre isso e quais são as suas perspectivas para após a luta?
Many people are saying that Chael Sonnen doesn't deserve to have this rematch. And how do you feel? And how are we going to feel after the fight?
Pessoal, eu também acho que ele não merece lutar. Mas eu sou um funcionário do UFC e estou para lutar. Se eu tiver que espancar ele mais 10 vezes, isso vai acontecer. Não vai ter problema.
I also don't believe Chael deserves a rematch, but hey, you know, I'm an employee of the UFC, and if I have to go in there and beat his ass 10 more times, I'll beat his ass 10 more times.
This question is for Chael here. Chael, you like your steak medium rare. Dana, have you ever seen a fighter insert the personal life of another fighter like this, commenting on someone's wife? And Chael, did you feel that you had to raise the stakes that way because it's that personal for you that you would comment on Anderson's personal life?
Well, in fairness, why don't you give us the quote? Because I continually hear what I said, but nobody's actually got the exact quote. And it's evolved a number of times. This is still a family event. I've never used profanity. And I never used the, you know, a lot of this is getting changed a little bit. And I'm not backtracking from any of it. And it was great commentary, and I don't regret saying it. But at the same time, it wasn't said when it continually gets said that it's said, okay? People say it shouldn't be personal. Well, it is personal. This guy's coming over to my house and he's trying to steal, and I'm going to meet him at the door with closed fists, and that's the way it's going to go. Okay? I don't offer an apology, and I don't really care. And if he wants to act like his feelings are hurt, where has he been the last 2 years? Where was he the 4 years before that? Where was Rich Franklin at before that? I've called these guys, I've been the best for a long time. I didn't get my shot. And I really don't give a damn if it hurt his feelings.
And for Anderson, is that more offensive than the comments Chael made about Brazil?
Os comentários que ele falou da tua esposa é mais ofensivo para você que as coisas que ele falou do Brasil?
Olha só, nós fazemos parte de um grupo seleto de atletas que representam uma grande companhia, que é o UFC. E milhares de pessoas assistem o UFC. E o Chael foi totalmente feliz nos comentários dele em relação à minha esposa, em relação ao meu país. E isso reflete muito mal, não só para os americanos,